Now, originally, I'd planned to do Jonah Hex for today's review, but after reading reviews from the good people of Rotten Tomatoes, I decided against it. The movie apparently bombed so atrociously that I'm not about to waste 2 hours plus of my life on it, though maybe when it comes out in DVD, I'll review it just for shits and giggles. So, in its place, I present the makeup brand Urban Decay. Now, one might ask if a makeup brand can be properly steampunk. What would such a line of maquillage consist of? There are certainly steampunk perfumes, like those sold from our good friends at Black Phoenix, and those are simply scents great with a steampunk name. So, for the most part, it appears that a makeup claiming to be steampunk need merely have a steampunk name or names and be absurdly well-made. And, most assuredly, Urban Decay fits the bill. Makeup-wise, UD deals in virtually every kind of beauty substance, from eyeshadow to lipstick to foundation, all of which are great with bizarre names such as mildew, voodoo, and jailbait. Not necessarily explicitly steampunk, but the wacky titles in my mind certainly lend themselves to the mindset of a gearhead. Their strong point by far is their eye makeup, which is epitomized in their extravagant line of eyeshadows, eyeliner, and their truly spectacular mascara, specifically the type known as Big Fatty, which is my go-to substance when I want to make the young male humanoids come to the ground in front of my place of abode for a drink composed of milk and ice cream. There is, however, a downside to this wonderful brand, namely the obnoxiously high prices on most of their items. There is no better way to empty one's wallet than in buying Urban Decay makeup, a fact that has, sadly, driven me to find some of my maquillage elsewhere, and saving pennies for my more necessary items I can only come by there, see above, Big Fatty Mascara. In accordance with this is the fact that while UD deals in all kinds of makeup, their best products are most definitely their eye makeup and eye makeup related equipment, with their lipstick and lip gloss being decent and their foundation and skin items far from exciting. It is also annoying to me that I usually have to make a foray into a mall to purchase UD, a fact that may not be that big of an issue for most, but for me, a long-standing misanthrope, proves to be a highly aggravating chore as I elbow my best bustle-clad self around scrawny hobo bag-carrying, sunglass-wearing, spray-tan-applying creatures that claim to be female but I personally consider to be creatures from another planet. So, in the final assessment, UD has some good stuff and annoying prices. Buy the good items if you can scrape the cash together, but failing that, don't fret. I'll soon be reviewing less pricey Etsy stores that also deal in wonderful cosmetics. That's it for now. Next time I will be reviewing the short film Nickel Children. Check the description for a link to the teaser trailer. Ta!